Welcome back to another episode of Pokémon Scarlet. We are back in school. We defeated a gym leader the last time. We did some grinding to catch our Pokédex up, trying to get as many Pokémons to show Professor Jacques and get an achievement there. So we're back in school because there's new classes we have to attend, and I'm on the top of this mountain here. It's very nice. There's a tower over there. I don't know if we're ever going to see that portion of the school. There's a tree there. On the other side, there's something else too. Let's see if I can fly there. I climbed up here. That's the road that leads to Victory Road. I did not want to look at that yet. Didn't want to spoil myself. Yeah. So the Victory Road and the rest of the world is not part of the open world. Well, shucks. School's over there. Okay. Well. Gonna be able to climb to the top of the school. Darn it. I really wanted to. Alright, let's just go inside the school then. There's no new classes because I just defeated a gym. There's no new classes. What about no new activity either? Alright then. Well, I guess it's not updated after every class. That's okay. Let's go to. This is our progress so far. We just beat. What is this? Fortunata. Oh, it tells me Victory Road. 4 out of 8 badges. We're halfway there. Starfall 1 so far. Path of Legends. Okay, so we gotta catch up. There's 1, 2, 3 more star members. Set a destination there. Let's go. Yeah, that makes sense, because I was exploring the northwest side of Paldea, this water region, which got a bunch of lag. We explored all this area. Explored this area, caught a bunch of water Pokemon, caught a bunch of different Pokemon as well. It's an outbreak of Kilowattrels. Okay, so we're gonna have to make our way there, there, and there, so. Outbreak of Flabells, Floettes, Flabells, Floettes. Okay, let's proceed. We have to heal our Pokemon. It's not a Pokemon Center. And we're still getting some monies. Yes, the air out here truly is fine. Breathe deep. Hoo-ha. Jose the student. Spiders. So, an update. I have a Rotom, and I was able to get it to the electric water type, but I'm not using it. I decided I'm going to use Cloyster because of its ice type, its ice attacks. I don't know what to expect from the Elite Four other than I know that Hassel or Hazel is a dragon trainer, and I'm gonna need some ice type moves. I do have some fairy moves in mind, but I decided to keep Cloyster on the team then, rather than having an electric Rotom. Gyarados's, of course, specialty is in its attack power, so Thunderbolt isn't gonna do a whole lot of damage, but if I need to teach it Thunderbolt, we will do such things. Hello, go goods. You guys are staring at me and I don't like it. Oh god. Considered weak. Who's making me suspect that? I guess I can make an update to this video. Today we're going to revolve around the school, but since we don't need to go to school, we'll take on another member of Team Star. Get some progress going there. the reliable partner. I've noticed it's giving these titles. A Dratini and an Axew. Alright, we didn't want to do it, but we are in a cave, and hopefully I'll get some more of these in the next badge. Darn. Guess we'll have to go to the Ultra Ball. Yay! Frigipax's Ice Fin. Frigipax absorbs heat through its dorsal fin and converts the heat into ice energy. The higher the temperature, the more energy Frigipax stores. He's got a beauty mole of ice there. There's like Pokemon, like, on top of us that are making noises. Interesting. Hello, Gumshoes. Gumshoes. Gumshoesy-wissy. Gumshoes. So this is not a tunnel, it's just a cave. Well, shooks. It's a shiny Hawlucha. Why can't they sparkle in the overworld? Capture. Yeah. Wow, it just came right out there. Amazing. Wow. I didn't want to press that. Okay. Well, there's Pokemon in the ting. episode off grinding. Just to, not grinding, capturing Pokemon. Do you know Hazel? Hassel? Hassel? Whatever. The animation, it's already going slow, so you know it hit. Or at the very least, you know it hit. You really gotta fix that patch. You gotta patch that up. You are strong. Better believe it. Alright, so let's go straight to Team Star. No more distractions. I'll come back and catch Pokemon. Haven't caught before at a later time. It's Snover. Bleep bleep bleep. Bleep 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 bleep. I hear him. You're the gimme ghoul. Whoa. Yes, I like to bat. I'm floating! Can I sell some stuff? Holy moly. We ballin' now. Found a bunch of pearls in that water area I told you guys about. I hear you. Oh, hey, Snover. Delibird. I hear you, Gimme Ghoul. Where are you? I think I'm gonna sneeze. The heck was that noise? Alright. It's not gonna distract him. We have to go over here now. Look at the sneasel run. Never seen it run. Yeah. We'll come back to explore this area at a later time. I can do it off camera. I can do it just a casual. Never melt ice. I can do it very casually with you guys just watching me. If you guys want to see that, let me know. If you guys enjoy me doing that, let me know. There's the... there's Team Star. Yeah. Not really, sir. But I will. I most certainly will. Did I use it? Did I have to use it, don't I, in order to... Dragon type Pokemon Snowscape Might. I haven't come across the Pokemon required to make that. It's gonna be all made here, I know. Icy Wind, Ice Fang. Okay, so Gyarados can probably learn Ice Fang. See if I can uncover Ice Beam or something like that. I just healed, but I think I have to heal so I can be registered into the map so I can fly here. Thank you. Alright, Team Star. Here we go. I'm gonna save it here just in case the game decides to crash or anything like that. Thankfully, it only happened once, and it was after a terror raid. Ah, it's you, Kaleo. I'll be so upset if it's not Clavel at all. It turns out to be an actual person named Clive. Like I said before, the name's Clive. Please don't forget it. Anyway, Kaleo, I owe you one. Thanks to you, I've been accepted into Operation Starfall. What's your endgame? I need answers, that's all. How do I resolve the situation with Team Star and what's causing its members' odd behavior? Odd behavior? Team Star is a subject of more than a few nasty rumors swirling around the academy, you know? Some say their bullying has caused a worrying number of students to drop out of school. Others say they're holed up in their bases plotting to cause trouble for the academy. But these are rumors. The matter I am directly confronting with is something else. I'm talking about Team Star's persistent truancy. They've all been skipping class for a while now. Five of them in particular, the so-called bosses of Team Star, haven't so much as set foot inside a classroom for over a year. And it seems the team's rank and file have recently started stirring up mischief as well. That's why I took it upon myself to issue a direct order to Team Star to disband. I informed them that should they refuse, I would have no choice but to expel all students affiliated with their team. But I'm afraid there's been no response, and the deadline is set for them to make their choice. Between disillusion or expulsion is nigh upon us. So you see, when I overheard you talking on the phone to Cassiopeia, it couldn't have come at a more crucial time. It's Cassiopeia, can you hear me? Oh, whisper another time then. Be careful. I see you're coming up to one of Team Star's bases. Was there someone else with you just now? That Team Star will have its guard up after losing one boss to you already. This base won't go down as easily as the last one. Proceed with extreme caution. I'll be in touch. Whew. Okay, but before I was so rudely interrupted... Oh, a Lilacant. Oh man, this is another place I haven't been in before. Cutscenes. I'll return later when it's time for the young master's piano lessons. Until then, please give me my regards. Yes, yes, Mr. Harrington. And who might you be, young man? A friend or of the young master's, perhaps? I see. Since you seem unaware, I must inform you that this is the base of Team Star's fairy crew, the Rukba squad, led by young Master Ortega. Oh, Mr. Harrington, I don't think we're supposed to be giving out that information. No? Then please accept my apologies. Do you have any idea as to who this young man might be? He's no friend of ours, you know. I think he might be here to try and take us on. Understood. In that case, I take it you're an adversary of the young master. I guess that follows. Is that so? Well then, that leaves me with one last thing to ask of you. Would you be so kind as to indulge me in a quick battle?
Sure.
Let us begin. Why are you giving the Team Star theme to him? He's our music teacher. You were a rocker back in the day, huh, Mr. Harrington? Joined a punk band back in the day. I feel like this is the longest I've actually heard the music. It sounds really cool. Dang, that was getting pretty good. Now I was getting into the music. Well, well. An outstanding performance. However, be aware that young Master Ortega's battle prowess far surpasses my paltry skills. You would do well to take care. Now, if you'll excuse me, hasta la vista. That gentlemanly guy used to be the director of the academy, I think. At least that's what I heard. Now he's, like, tutoring the boss or something. He shows up here sometimes to take the boss to his lessons. Hang on, why am I explaining this to you? There's no doubting you're here to make trouble, so I gotta go let everyone know. Hasta la vista, yeah. I see the guard has been dealt with. Good job. The base belongs to Team Star's ferry crew, the Rush Boss Squad. Their boss Ortega is the mechanic of the team. He may be the youngest of the bosses, but his battle skills are no joke. Underestimate him and things will go south for you quickly. He's also a real lead from the back type. He gets his grunts to do all his dirty work for him, but his weak points in his short fuse. Get him good and angry and he'll march out of the front lines to deal with him yourself. In terms of tactics, there's nothing else for it but to take down all the lackeys he sends your way. Just tough it out until Ortega shows up and go from there. Ring the bell at the gate once you are ready to kick off this phase of the operation. Time to wipe the Rush Boss Squad off the map. So many storylines. So, same as before, first three. I think they're weak to fighting. Maybe not Azumarill. Man, fighting, steel, and poison. I don't have any poison. I heard something. Where are you? Dang, that's a lot of Pokemon. Where'd you go? I heard you. ready to challenge you to start using the first three Pokemon in your party? Yes. So it's Dark, Fighting, Poison, Fairy, Fire. Some kid lucked out beating one of our sister squads, and now he thinks he can take us on. Time to give him a brute, gang. Let's show this Gate Crusher what Team Star can do. And if you're listening, Gate Crusher, know this. Unless you can defeat 30 of our Pokemon in 10 minutes, our boss will lift a finger to deal with the likes of you. It's stopped raining. Gardevoir? Better hurry up. There's a guard, psychic type. Oh my gosh. Are you guys part of the Pokemon team? Psychic. Content. Oh my gosh, you guys have fairy types of all kind here. We're getting a bunch of like bodies of grass type. Our defense is our breach. It's all up to the boss now. Ooh, pink. That's interesting. I didn't know they changed colors. That's cool. Oh man. Huh, so you're a Kaleo. Okay. Talk about underwhelming. I was expecting someone, I don't know, a little more beefed up. Well, whatever. I don't care who you are. Not like I'm gonna lose to you anyway. If you think fairy types are all about cuteness, you're in for a nasty surprise. Oh boy. Team Star Boss. Luxury Ball. Very nice. I promise I'll play nice, so don't blame me when the battle sends you blubbering back to me. Oh my, 50. Oh, so very. It's fighting. I had it wrong. Thank you. he's good against dragons, fighting, and dark types. Man. Can I really use the steel type move here? Where's it? Dash button. Yes. It's a. Oh, but it's not a. It's the dog's a normal type. Its evolution is a very normal. Crackers. Faster than me too. Crazy. Special attacks. Nice. If I remember, gosh, what is the engine? Fire, poison, fire, steel, steel and poison. I think it's steel and poison. Lag is real. Holy moly. Oh, was a bright and sunny day until I made it dark. Way to go! How could I lose? What the heck? About a year and a half ago. Your toy car didn't budge an inch, huh? I told you, it's not a toy. It's called the Starmobile, and I was up all night building it. The problem's clearly that we're not giving it enough juice. You designed this thing to be powered by two char cadets, but it's just too heavy. That's such a shame. I wanted to see the looks of on our bullies' faces once we got it moving. I'm sorry, I really thought it would work. Come, good fellow, 'tis no occasion for melancholy. Why, to make such a remarkable contraption by thine own hand? Genius, thy name is Ortega. Yeah, well, there's no point of it if it doesn't work, is there? If I knew all that effort would have zero payout, I'd have just asked Mother to buy a car for us. See, this is why people don't take you seriously. You say some stupid things, you know? Mela, cool it, would you? Yeah, how about no? I mean, we even put this in the code, for crying out loud. When we started Team Star, we swore to quit relying on our parents or bags of cash to fix our problems for us. Or did you forget? If that hunk of junk doesn't move, get it moving. If we're short on juice, just gotta crank up the power somehow. Doesn't take a genius, man. That's easy enough to say, Millie. Do you have an actual plan? Yep, I'm gonna train up my Charcadet and have him evolve their boosted firepower will get the Starmobile moving, no sweat. But the hour of Operation Star is nigh at hand. Will you succeed in time? Well, I'll get it done. Millie, wait. You know Mela shoots her mouth off at an awful lot, but she means well. I know. I hate myself for losing, but I also can't get over how awesome you are in that battle. If any of us squad bosses are defeated, that means we have to step down, and going against our code would make me a traitor to the team. Gah, fine. Not like I have a choice anyway, so take the badge already. You better treat it with the respect it deserves. Not done yet. Here's my favorite TM2. Dazzling. And just so you know, you are the worst. Like, the most annoying person ever. Excuse me, but I get it. You're super strong. I admit that much. You even busted up my Starmobile. Young Master Ortega. Mr. Harrington. I guess it's time for my piano lesson, huh? As it happens, I just lost my boss title, so I'm all good to head on home. Ah, actually, a different matter brought me. There's somebody I would like you to meet. He's a distant acquaintance of mine. The name's Clav. Okay, what's your business here? I want you to tell me something. You're the son of a wealthy family and heir to the major apparel company, so why join a group like Team Star? What a question to ask someone you've just met. Well, my answer's the same as everyone else in the team. It's because I was being bullied. So the academy really did use to have an issue with bullying. Who would guess, right? The school is all rainbows and butterflies these days, and the bullies from back then don't even go to the academy anymore. Why? What happened to them? As the former director of the academy, I believe I am best positioned to answer this question, Mr. Harrington. About 18 months ago, the members of Team Star confronted the students who used to bully them. Then an altercation broke out between the groups. Though it did not escalate into a major incident, the altercation nonetheless caused a scandal of hitherto unknown proportions. As a result of what occurred that day, the students who had perpetrated the bullying dropped out of the academy one after another. But there aren't any records of that anywhere in the academy. No, I should imagine not. My former deputy deleted all the records of the incident, you see. Why would anyone do that? Just as I was puzzling over how best to deal with Team Star in the aftermath of the incident, a certain student came to see me. This student declared that they would take all responsibility for the team's actions. In exchange, they requested that I exonerate the other students of Team Star from any blame. No one told me that. I accepted the request and agreed not to take disciplinary action against Team Star. Then I assigned 18 months of overseas study to the student who took responsibility to the team. A year and a half of studying abroad. This was not intended as a punishment, you understand. Team Star were the victim, after all. I wanted the students to take some time to rest, so I had them return home to the Galar region, under the pretext of overseas study. Around that time, however, the former deputy director took it upon himself to erase all traces of the incident from the Academy's servers. Erase. The deputy is the one doing this, maybe. It appears his intent was to shield himself from any blame. So he tried to cover up the whole thing. That's terrible. After we discovered what he had done, I dealt with him appropriately, of course. But the inability of myself and the rest of the teaching staff to prevent this terrible act also represented a grave blunder on our part. I accepted the blame that day at my feet and resigned from my position as director. The rest of the teaching staff then joined me in handing in their notices. So that's why the current teachers were all brought in a year and a half ago. I understand my actions have caused you a great deal of trouble. You have my sincere apologies. Hang on, Mr. Harrington. How come you suddenly decided to talk about this now? Young Master Ortega, Team Star cannot carry on in its current fashion. I merely wish to give you a chance to chart a better course. Well, there's no way I'm abandoning my friends and going to school without them, not after we've come this far. Your friends and Team Star must mean a great deal to you. Isn't that obvious? It's because you know they're my greatest treasure in the whole world.
Aww.
Screenshot. Wallpaper. Kaleo, it's me. I take it Ortega's star badge is now in your possession? I see. With its boss no longer around, the Rush Boss squad is good as finished. Ortega. Sorry, I got distracted for a second there again. Now about your reward. I'll transfer some LP over to your phone as promised. New TMs. Use those new TMs to strengthen your Pokemon even further. I'll have my supply unit rep meet you shortly to deliver some bonus materials. What up, Penny? Agias. What the heck? Stop that. Somebody help. 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 Blah, it drooled all over me. What even is that Pokemon anyway? Yo, it's really awesome. That's one word. Oh, wait, is it really that special? Oh, but I forget. Here's your reward.
Yay.
Your name's Kaleo. Since you're part of the Operation Starfall Batter unit, can I ask you something? What do you think of Team Star?
They're pretty strong.
Interesting. You know, some of the rumors say Team Star wasn't always a bunch of delinquents. Most of them used to be victims of bullying, or they just found it hard to interact with people. But then these misfits and outsiders found each other and banded together to form Team Star. And they wanted to do... All they wanted to do was push back against the bullies they couldn't face alone. But that's just info I got by hacking other students' social media accounts. Oh, I also found talk about some secret mastermind behind the five bosses, someone who recruited them to the team in the first place. I don't normally talk this much, now my throat kinda hurts. So good luck with taking down the other bases and stuff. Where'd you get that Eevee? Hot Topic? Was it Spencer's? Where can I get one? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we did it. We did it. And we are going to find first this... There you are. I knew you were behind there. Alright. So, can I climb that? Battle of Team Star, that concludes this episode. Gonna take a look at what's that over there. Think I can climb that tower. Yeah. Is that a psychic type? Psychic type Swablu? At the time of this video, I think the other raid is going on, the Dragonite and the Salamence. I don't think I'm strong enough to take them on. See the denim material that hacked. So shiny. Bleep 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 bleep. Alright. Let's climb this tower. Anything behind here? Yep. There's a trainer there. Puppies. Yeah.
Energy ball. Nice. Alright, everybody. We did it. The next chapter in our next episode is gonna be... There's a gym there. One's ice, one's ghost. Interesting. I have 4 badges, 5, 6. 5, 6. Oh, that girl. 7 and 8. No, 8. That's Team Star. 8. 7 and 8. And there's 2 more beasts. So, we're gonna be knocking these out. We're gonna do gym, they're right next to each other. Might as well, gym. Yeah, how about we do that next episode? So next episode lineup will be gym, me. Nah, let's keep it fresh. We'll do gym, star, beast, Gym Star Gym. Alright, so we kind of have a pattern going on. Excuse me. Alright, so the next episode, we'll take on a gym battle. Ice type. So I'll see you guys in the next episode. Like and subscribe as always. Let me know how your adventure's coming along. Are you way past me? I bet you are. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Laters.